Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 13.2 Beta 2 has been out for a little while for both public beta testers and developers. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. I also have it on some other devices such as the iPad Air 2. So I wanted to go over a couple of the features that I missed in my What's New video that I found afterwards, or people talked about afterwards, and also something that's coming a little bit later, and then also talk about how it's been for me, how it's been for you, and then we'll go over the YouTube community. Poll. If you want to jump to any of those sections, check the time codes below that are in the description, and hopefully that will help you see the part that you're interested in the most. Now, over 11,000 of you responded to the poll, so we have some good information as far as how good it is for people, if they should install it, and how it will be for people in the future. Now, one of the features I missed in the What's New video had to do with Safari. So if you go into Safari, and then you long press on any link in Safari, you used to be able to hide the link preview. Now you can still do that, but instead of including it in this menu, they've put it here at the top. So that's just a little UI change or user interface change. And I don't know if it's any better or worse, but they've moved it. They've also changed the menu when you hit the two A's, where you can adjust the font size and the toolbar and select different fonts if you have them. This is now separated into smaller sections and is no longer one big scrolling page. So now it's just a little bit more compact. You can see things a little bit better. So that's the new thing with Safari. There's also some changes in maps. So if I go into maps, when you're in maps, if you're in a city such as New York City, and you have the options for, say, flyover and directions, some people are seeing these as large bars, or you'll see them side by side. This can change depending on what you're in. So maybe you want to do flyover. You can fly over New York City, takes a moment to load, and you can do a city tour and fly over the city this way. So it's a pretty interesting feature. It's not available in every city. It's available in large cities like San Francisco, New York, and those. If we go over to San Francisco, you'll see flyover and directions are side by side. This may or may not be different for you. Now there's something else coming. We know AirPods 3 are coming. Some are saying that it's coming at the end of October with a new Apple event. Others are saying there is no Apple event. It just depends what Apple does. We don't really know for sure, but if we go into Twitter, Guy Rambo actually found a new animation in iOS 13.2 that teaches users how to change noise cancellation within their headphones if they had AirPods 3. So you'll see, you'll have a little switch here where you can turn it on and off, and that allows you to turn noise cancellation on and off. It's not available other than something they found in the code. Guy Rambo is pretty good at finding that stuff. And if you haven't seen any of his different information, you may want to follow him if you're into all of that behind the scenes things that may not show up in the code just yet. Now, as far as issues I've had with this beta, I actually have not had too many except for connectivity. And connectivity continues to be an issue for me, and I've reported it in feedback. I assumed a lot of you had the issue, but not as many with the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And the issue that I have is not signal strength or anything like that. I actually have excellent signal strength, but it's when I leave a Wi-Fi network, maybe I go away from the building where I had Wi-Fi, all of a sudden LTE won't work. It's like it won't connect. And this is not a carrier issue. I've known about a lot of people with AT&T, T-Mobile, Sprint, Verizon in the United States, and others around the world having similar issues. And so I actually reported it in the feedback app, and Apple got back to me and asked for more information to try and troubleshoot this even more. So hopefully they fix that in the next beta or the next couple betas for everyone once iOS 13.2 comes out to the XS Max and those devices having similar issues. Now, RAM management is actually pretty good. I've really not had too many issues with the exception of Google applications. So if I open YouTube, for example, it often reloads. If I go into an Apple application such as Safari, most of the time it doesn't reload. So I think this may be a change in the code to iOS 13.2, and YouTube or Google and other application developers need to update their apps. I'm not sure. We'll only really know over time, but it's hard to say at this point. Now, as far as battery life, everyone wants to know how battery life is. And for me, let's take a look. I actually have not checked it because I've had great battery life. So let's see what it comes up with. We'll go to the last 10 days and you'll see I had with over 50% battery life left. I had 3 hours and 37 minutes. Now, I would say that this battery life is not phenomenal, but I do have a lot of things running a lot of the time, Twitter 25% of the time, and maybe some applications in the background as well. Prior to this update, I actually had better battery life most of the time. But I would say 7 to 8 hours is normal on this phone, maybe even 9 hours, depending on what you're doing on an 11 Pro Max. So I think it needs some improvement. However, if we talk about your experience, some people said they had phenomenal battery life. Other people said it was horrible. Most of the people that said it was horrible were on the iPhone SE or the iPhone 7. So these older phones that have different chipsets in them apparently are having some issues with battery. Hopefully Apple updates that. But there really were not a whole lot of complaints as far as speed and performance. For me, performance has been great, and many of you said the exact same thing. No performance issues whatsoever, with the exception of a couple of you. Now, I wanted to talk about a couple of the bugs that you've reported as well that many people are reporting based on your comments on the YouTube community poll. Now, one of the issues many of you reported was screen flickering. I was not able to reproduce this no matter what I did, changed brightness, went into widgets, anything. I could not get this to crash or have screen flickering whatsoever. Another thing many of you are reporting is that assistive touch doesn't work, and specifically with the custom app switcher. The action isn't working for some people. So if you're using that specific thing, it may not be working. And then some others were saying that one day it may be fine, and then they'll go into an application and then it will crash. And then maybe the next set of applications will crash the next day. I have not had not one application crash. So I've been playing Call of Duty a little bit. I've been using my Tesla app, the Home app, all of the things on my main page I use pretty much daily, and I have had zero crashes. I've also had no issues with mail, and many of you have not had issues with mail either. So it seems like it's fixed in beta 2 for the majority of people. Now on the iPad, a couple people reported issues with the keyboard, and that makes sense. The keyboard is a little bit different on the iPad. So if we go into Safari and maybe bring up the keyboard here, people were saying that it would just disappear and they couldn't get it back. And then when you have the smaller keyboard, sometimes moving it around, it just may disappear. So you may not be able to use it and have an issue. Also, Apple had an issue with some of the newer iPad Pro devices bricking with this update. And they actually pulled the IPSW file from the developer site when it bricked the iPad. So for some people, they were having that issue. I thankfully did not update my iPad Pro second generation. So I didn't have that issue. It worked fine on my iPad Air 2. So I guess it just depends on which device you're actually using. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now the YouTube community poll has 11,000 votes, so over 11,000 votes, with 187 comments at the time of this video. And 22% of you said that it was great. 3% said it was terrible, which is pretty low actually, and 9% said it has some bugs. And then 57% of you stayed on public versions, which is probably a good idea instead of running early betas. And you're probably sick of that if you've been on the earlier iOS 13 betas. And then 9% of you use Android. So thank you for participating, even though this isn't really relevant to you if you use Android. Now, I've read all of these comments, but let me sort them by the oldest first, and we'll go through some of them. And I try to cover all of the devices because I can't possibly use all of the devices at once. And many people are saying, can you show me the iPhone 8 or the iPhone 7 and those sorts of things? And I actually could, but the performance isn't any different according to all of you. So there's no difference in performance. A few of you are saying differences in battery life. So let's take a look at the comments. It says, I don't like how they made the LTE status less bold, like how it was when iOS 13 first came out. Now I had seen some things about this. I don't notice it to be less bold. I guess I'm just not seeing that. It looks the same to me, but for some people they're seeing it different. So they may change that back. I've been experiencing problems with silence to unknown callers, and dictation doesn't work sometimes. Lastly, for me, Siri doesn't read texts aloud when you're in your car or in the car. I've heard that that may be happening to some people, but it wasn't widespread from what I had read. Many people were saying that Siri wasn't working specifically with third-party messaging applications, but it should be working with messages itself. The update has been the best so far, in my opinion. There aren't as many noticeable bugs with the system. Assistive touch doesn't work properly yesterday, but it's fine now on my iPhone SE. Again, one right below it, assistive touch, yes, I use that, isn't working properly. The app switcher custom action doesn't work. It's been all right on my iPhone XS Max. No major bugs for me this time. 11 Pro Max and iPad Pro 2018, really solid on both. On the 11 Pro Max, it's really smooth and getting about 7 hours of screen on time right now. Hopefully more soon. Only weird bug I've had was on my iPad Pro. I uninstalled all of the apps that were in a folder, and the empty folder wouldn't go away to show the home screen until a reboot. It's kind of an odd issue, but at least it's working for you, I suppose. iPhone 8, no problems. Battery life, excellent. Disappointed that you cannot change video mode from camera app. Animation's not working automatically. And if you hadn't seen that in my What's New video, that's one of the best things they've done finally, is only on the iPhone 11, 11 Pro, and Pro Max, for some reason, you can change the frame rates of the video within the app, but not on iPhone 8 and the other devices. That makes zero sense, so hopefully Apple actually updates that soon. So this is weird. I've been using iOS 13.1.2 before I updated to 13.2 beta 2, and my phone felt smoother and less buggy after the update. So does that mean beta equals more stable than a public release? Apple is making no sense. A beta means there's more bug fixes is really what it means. It means there could be other issues you experience and your phone could be unstable, but it may not be. So it's hit or miss, as you'll see with these comments. This is a good question. Can we expect any further update on 13.1.2 because 13.1.2 is still very buggy on my XR? That depends. If there is a security issue or a major bug, Apple may push out 13.1.3. They don't tend to push out a 0.3 or the third number out update unless there's a serious security issue or bug. They'll wait until 13.2, which is probably about a month away or so, something about around that time. Using iPhone 7 Plus, still some app crashes, including system apps crashes. Here's someone without mail or with mail issues. XS Max, mail app unusable for the first time for me. Had to install Outlook app instead. Excellent battery life. iOS 13.2 Beta 2 runs great on my XR. Battery life is decent. iPhone 11 Pro, location arrow pops up every time I pick up my phone. Problem is that none of the apps and services have purple arrows. Disabling all system services doesn't solve this issue, as the arrow is still shown in the status bar. Had to disable location services, only this fixed the problem. Also, swiping between home screen and widgets is sometimes very choppy. I wouldn't worry too much about the location issue. That's usually doing something in the background. Who knows what it's doing, but if it's all of your applications are off, it could be some system level thing that's being done just in the beta. It's hard to say though. iPhone XS, no problem so far. Great battery life. iOS 13.2 beta 2 on my iPhone 7 is fantastic. It's very stable and I never had an issue with the battery on this version. It's great on my iPhone, but bricked my iPad. iPad Pro 2018 12.9. You should be able to get that back by using Restore in iTunes, but that's still no fun to deal with. Worst case is you'd have to bring it to Apple. Should I install iPhone XR? I normally say if you ask that question, you definitely should not install. If you don't care about dealing with bugs or having issues and then reporting those to Apple, it's kind of the way of beta testing. If you don't mind doing that, then go ahead and install it. Otherwise, just wait until the final comes out. I'm on the iPhone 11 Pro Max. I've had no issues so far, other than I believe I'm having a problem with wireless charging. I've noticed after the update, it's not working most of the time. You may want to check your wireless charger because that's something, unless it's a hardware issue, it either works or it doesn't. It's not something that usually can just be stopped because of software. It's normally a hardware thing. So try a different wireless charger, perhaps. I'm using it on the iPad 5th gen. It's okay, but it's just the battery life that is letting the software down at this moment. It's a shame, but apart from that, it's great. Great on my iPhone SE. iPhone 7, terrible battery drain, just on standby. I worked a 12-hour shift without touching my phone, and it was at 72% from 100% without any apps in the background. If your phone was on Wi-Fi by any chance, it could have been doing updates and things in the background. It's possible that it was on Wi-Fi and doing that if you have access at work. If not, it's something else. RAM management isn't very bad on my iPhone 10, but battery is very good. I think you meant to say it was very bad. Again, I think it's specific to apps that are having RAM management issues. I recorded a movie using Screen Recorder. It ended up being over 10 gigs because Screen Recorder records at 60 frames per second. Is there any way to change this? It may go along with your camera settings, but you really want the screen recording to be at 60 frames per second, since that's what the display actually runs at. So you want to use that, and then you can change it later in a an app like Final Cut or iMovie or something like that and delete it from your phone. I have issues with the camera and photos app on my iPhone 11. I'd like to know specifically what you mean by that, though. It's been actually pretty good for me on this beta. I haven't experienced any bugs apart from a couple background refreshes. Battery seems fine, haven't had to enable low power mode yet. Performance also seems better, and bonus tweaks make it all the better. Upgraded from iOS 13.1.2 on an iPhone 8, 64GB with 98% battery health. iPhone 8, the battery is okay, the performance is very fast, but there are two issues with the RAM management keeps reloading the apps without closing the apps, and sometimes the touch doesn't respond. I actually have that touch response issue on my iPad Pro, even on the public version, so there's something going on with that. And then finally, iOS 13 is going great, I'm using it on my iPhone 8, and everything is running smoothly. So that's it for iOS 13.2 Beta 2. Let me know how it's going for you in the comments below. And if you're looking for the next update, expect it either later this week or next week as far as Beta 3. If you have any other questions, though, let me know in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.